When you're playing any game which uses a dice, instead of using a dice, try using jumping beans. So we've got some in here, throw them out, and the score would be just the ones that have landed with their coloured side up. So the score here would be 3. Now, if we do that, we can change playing any game into a more powerful mathematical learning experience. I'm going to show you how to make these beans. Okay, so we're going to start with just some dried butter beans. We're just going to colour one side of those, and you can do that in lots of different ways. You could use sticky dots, just stick them onto one side. We're just colouring one side, so stay in play on that side, got a sticky dot on that side, or you could use a permanent marker just to draw a mark, doesn't matter what shape it is, or you could use acrylic paint. Or my favourite is to use some old nail varnish. That stays on quite easily. If you want these in a hurry, then you can speed the drying up with a hairdryer. It's quite useful to have a little pot, put your set in. If you make a set of about 15, you've then got the possibility of either choosing to use all 15 of them at once, or you could try actually giving each player the chance to choose how many they want to throw. So they might actually want a small number the next turn, so they might choose to throw less than the whole set. And all of those choices create really good mathematical learning opportunities. Jumping beans. For more ideas on how to use jumping beans to help your child with maths, go to numberchase.co.uk.